Alright, now today I'm going to be showing you a possible setup you could buy for around $700 or £540. Now, you don't actually have to go out and buy every single thing mentioned in today's video. You could maybe swap out the monitor for something else or the keyboard, but we basically used what we had available and that was the parts we selected for today's build. Now, the PC isn't included in the budget, but if you do want to see another episode like this and you want the PC included, then make sure to click that thumbs up button and let me know in the comments below. Obviously suggesting a different price tag and also with the PC included. Also, before I get started, everything will be listed in the description below for you guys to go ahead and directly purchase. And yeah, that's about it. All right, guys, let's get started. So for this setup, we chose a cheap desk from John Lewis here in the UK. Now it goes for around £50 or $80. However, there are alternatives like the Linman table from IKEA, which is actually really good. Nevertheless, this desk is clean and the wooden finish on it really makes for a clean look. Now for the monitor, I went with a 1080p Acer 21.5-inch monitor, which is $90, and for this price tag, I can't complain. It has a sturdy build and the colors are very accurate on this display. It has all of the necessary ports you would need, a DVI and a VGA port. Overall, a solid 1080p monitor and it can definitely fit in with this setup. As for peripherals, these are usually personal preference, but for this budget, we went with the Logitech G610 for $90, and you can buy it in the Cherry Mix red, brown, and blue switches, and we chose the red switches purely because it's really good for gaming. Now, this keyboard has a volume wheel at the top and also a gaming key which disables the Windows key, which is really practical. For under $100, this is probably within the best keyboards you can buy for this price tag just because of how many features it packs and how sturdy the build quality is. Now, the mouse is actually an Anker mouse for $30, which works perfectly fine for gaming and editing. It has multiple different colors to match any theme setup and also has a back and forward button which are conveniently placed. Both of these peripherals are really good and I've been using both of these for over a month or so, so I can highly recommend them. In my opinion, the chair is the most important part of a setup. In this case, we went with the GT Omega Pro Racing Office Chair, and trust me, if there was just one thing you could buy in this setup, I would definitely go for the GT Omega chair just because of how good it is. First off, the design is so sleek and unique. Yep, that rhymed, but I can tell it resembles a high-end car seat. It has lumbar support and also a headrest, both made out of some sort of memory foam padding. Oh, and also it is flexible in terms of you can basically lie back on the chair, which I actually use quite often as you can just sit back and relax. Now, GT Omega sent out the black and white chair. However, there are different color options you could go for. There's loads and loads to choose from, so they will definitely match your setup's theme. Moving on, the two lamps either side are from IKEA and you can get both of them for around $30. They aren't the best built lamps, but they do the job, and if you do want to add some ambience into your setup, then I would suggest to pick up a smart bulb like the one I have right there. I have a Lifex, but it's not included, and even if you go for a standard bulb, it will still look great. Lastly is the audio section. For headphones, I chose the Azaton Pro HE7s, which I've been using for over a year now, and they still do the job and have. I use these for editing videos, gaming, and consuming media, and they are overall a great pair of headphones for the price of only $30. Now, what about if you want a speaker? Then for this setup, I used the Symphony speaker, and this thing is tiny yet packs a punch. I'm not even exaggerating when I say this, but this is probably one of the best Bluetooth speakers I've ever tested. It is extremely loud and the wooden build makes it look sleek, not to mention you can connect it to your PC, and overall it is an awesome compact speaker. And that is a setup you could build for under $700. Anyway guys, that's gonna do it for today's video. It would make my day if you did something so simple by just clicking that thumbs up button. It only takes a few seconds. Also, make sure to follow me on Instagram because I'm actually posting one photo every single day for 30 days, so I'm actually posting some really interesting pictures. And also, I have a second channel linked in the description below where I just reacted to some old videos, definitely interesting to say the least. Now, lastly, comment down below hashtag Nutella if you watched this far into the video, and that's pretty much it. Anyway guys, I'm Hamza from Super Extreme Video, and I'll talk to you in the next one. Later, lads. Bye.
Her body's gold like September. She burns through the night like an ember.